Hi guys, welcome to ItsDanK Reviews. We're having a look at Windows 8, everyone's favorite operating system. And I say that sort of sarcastically because a lot of people don't like it, but I think that's down to not understanding the operating system rather than how it actually functions, because it pretty much functions identically to Windows 7 without the start button. And that's pretty much all you have to get used to. So you can, you know, rename stuff. You can drag stuff across. I've just mouse and control scrolled, so that's fairly easy. I'm gonna put all of the shortcuts in the links description below so you guys can have a look at that. And say if I am on the weekend, I want to have a look at people more, I can drag that. Or if I want to see the news more, I can drag that across. And it's just that easy. I just zoom in and I can go straight into applications. One of the applications Windows tab. One of the applications I go to most is SBS On Demand, and I pretty much stream the news from here, so I don't really turn the TV on that much. And there are plenty of applications, really good applications out there. They're not very hard to find. I just pretty much look at the free ones. This is your store, and it tells you what your updates are. And it doesn't always automatically update, which is a bit annoying. But Windows D gets you into your desktop. That's never changed. That's pretty much been the same. And everyone's pretty... all very familiar here, except for the start button's missing. And we'll go through some shortcuts. So Windows C gets the charm bars up, and you can pretty much, you can search, you can look at your settings, shut down the computer, change your PC settings as well, which is all fairly standard, and that's not very difficult. Windows X brings up, like, you can go up to device manager, disk management, all of your sort of admin stuff is in one place. And you've also got Windows R, which has always been run. And I want to show you something, because this is msconfig I've typed in here. And usually, this is where you tweak your startup items. So you'd be able to go into Task Manager and change stuff. So instead of actually, they're moving a lot of stuff that used to be hidden away, like your startup tools. They've moved that to Task Manager, which is really cool. So I can actually change a lot of the programs that I want to have started up, and can go into processes. I can sort of look at what's taking up the most CPU, for example. You can see my screen capturing software is doing that, and it gives you nice little graphs. And it's implemented a lot of these graphs, performance graphs, in quite a few things, not just here. If we go to video, which is on my launcher, I put this launcher down below in the links description. It's just an optional launcher. It lets me dock folders, and I can't actually dock folders on here, not very well anyway, because I'd have to right click and get into them. There's too many clicks for me. So this dock, I think it's called Nexus Dock. You can find it in the link description below. I quite like it. There we go. So it gives you a graph of the speed. So I'm doing 300 megabytes per second. My burst rate's ending. Oh, I'm doing 275 megabytes a second. Sorry. And it's a really nice performance graph. It tells you how far it is complete, and you can do multiple copies as well. But since it copied it so fast, it's just insane. That's pretty much Windows 8. I mean, there's not really much to it. There's a few shortcuts that you should get used to. I mean, if you hit the Windows key, for example, and type in any program. So if I want Internet Explorer, I can hit IE, Internet Explorer comes up. And I can do anything. I can type device manager, and I can click into settings, see here, and there it is. It's very, very easy to find files, apps, anything, just using the one search. So if you search one thing, it searches many things, and that's pretty much it. Like, it's not a very complicated system, Windows 8. It's pretty much the Windows 7 you like, with a bit more. You know, if you don't like the extra applications and stuff that come in the store, don't use them. But overall, I think, you know, this is the future. Get used to it, pretty much. And you know, it's not as bad as everyone says it is. It's just getting used to the workflow, and I think that'll take a long time for quite a few people. So it's been Dan K. Have a look at this doc, because I really like this doc actually. And yeah, do subscribe to the channel. I'll put a subscribe button here somewhere for you guys. And it's, as I said, been Dan K. Have a look at some of our other videos, and I will see you guys next time.